Hi people, welcome to my channel. I'm Arpita Karwa and this is a video which is going to deal with one of the most important topics of UGC NET English Literature Paper 2. Last year, I'm pretty sure that you must have seen that there was a slight change in the syllabus and few new topics were added. Now, as I've always been telling my students that these topics were added officially on the syllabus, but they were earlier also asking questions from these topics. So you need to understand the fact that you don't need to actually worry about the topics because these are very easy. And one such topic is language and pedagogy. Now, language and pedagogy basically is a part of linguistics, which is another subject altogether of UGC NET examination. English literature is code number 30, whereas linguistics as a subject is code number 31. But yes, now that we know that English is becoming one of the widely known and widely spoken language, it is important for us to understand how to teach English to our students. And teaching English involves using certain methods so that the student can understand the language and then communicate effectively. And in order to master this technique, UGC NET have made an effort and put this in our syllabus so that we can understand various language learning techniques. So in this video, I'm going to look at some key techniques which is asked in NET exam. And you, once you understand these key techniques, you will be able to answer 3 to 4 questions which are asked from linguistics very easily. So don't worry, there are at least 3 or 4 questions asking about language and pedagogy, and we are going to master that by the end of this video. So let's get started. The first important language learning method is known as grammar method. Now, this is the oldest and the most traditional method of teaching any language to students. This method was used specifically to teach Greek and Latin during the classical period. So if you remember, in one of my audio lectures in my online course, I've discussed the classical literature, in which I have discussed what it means to have an academy in Greek, ancient Greece. So in ancient Greece, we had these philosophers like Socrates and Aristophanes, and they were having academies where they used to teach students. And the Latin and Greek were the languages that were taught. So the languages were taught according to this method. That is why it is known as grammar method, because the focus was too much on the grammar. If you have ever tried to master English language, tried to become better at spoken English, you must have come across these books by Rapidex or Salaam Chaus. Now, in these books, you will find out that they've given you exercises where there are sentences in Hindi. You have to translate that into English and vice versa. For example, ek sentence given hoga, main kursi par baitha hoon. Translate that into English. I'm sitting on the chair. Same way, they'll give you a sentence in English. I'm going to the market. Translate this into Hindi. This would be, main bazaar ja raha hoon. And this is how they try to teach you English as a language. So this method of translating a text or a line from mother tongue to the target language and vice versa is known as grammar method. A lot of times questions have been asked from grammar method. In December 2015, there was a question that which of the language teaching methods strategically makes the use of mother tongue? And the correct answer was grammar method. So make sure that you understand the basic idea about what grammar method is and you prepare yourself thoroughly for the exam. The next learning methodology is very interesting and is very close to my heart since I've been a psychologist and I've been a student of psychology. It was created by a psychologist himself called James Asher, and this is known as total physical response. Now, have you ever observed a child learning language? What his parents or his elder siblings do? They tell him, go to that door, open that door, give me that book, give that book to mama. This is how they talk to the child. And gradually you will see that the child starts learning. So what happens when a person talks to another person in this way? Basically, there's a brain connection that develops between action and the language. So there's a strong connection. When I say go shut the door and I point out towards the door, that means there is a wiring in the brain which says that, okay, door, if I'm pointing out at the door and I'm saying door, that means this object is called door. So this is total physical response, which is very kinesthetic. The children are asked to actually do things so that they learn quickly. And if you look at the nursery rhymes also, 1, 2, 3, buckle my shoe, all these poems that you look at, you will find that they are more about doing things. Sit on the floor, get up, sit down, eat this, give it. All these words, that is how the child is learning. So it is very much connected to the child psychology, and that is why this is the best method that parents use in order to teach a language to their kid. So make sure that if you want to ever understand or learn a new language, you use this technique, total physical response, and you understand how a strong connection, neural connection, can be built between an action and the vocabulary associated. Another interesting learning methodology is skill-based learning. I'm pretty sure that you must be aware that there are 4 language skills: reading, writing, listening, and speaking. If you want to master any language, you need to become better at all these 4 things. I've seen a lot of students who keep on watching TV shows or English news and still they can't pick up language so easily. They can't speak fluently. I have a lot of friends who are ardent readers. They read so much. Still, they struggle when it comes to spoken English. Have you ever wondered why? This particular teaching method is going to give you the answer. When you only focus on one aspect, one skill, you become better at that skill. If I focus on cooking Indian food, will I become better at cooking continental dishes? No. If I'm good at drawing, can I be good at guitar? No. If I practice drawing, I'll be good at drawing. If I practice guitar, I'll be good at guitar. The same thing applies to the 4 language skills. If you're reading a lot these days, you will find out that your reading speed would improve. If you're writing a lot, you will see that words are going to flow very easily. If you're practicing listening, you'll become better at listening. You might be using subtitles earlier, and later you might understand it without subtitles. But then by listening more, you can't become good at speaking. So skill-based learning actually tells you that you have to work on all the 4 skills if you want to become better at these 4 skills. Or if you want to become good at one particular skill, if I want to get into content writing, I want to become good at writing, it's better that I practice writing more. By reading or by speaking or by listening, I would not improve my writing skills. So this is the major idea behind the skill-based teaching, which is another important teaching methodology frequently asked in NET exam. Last but not the least is the language method which was developed during the World War II, and that is why it is also known as the Army method. So what's this method all about? It is known as audiolingual method. If you look at the World War II scenario, just when the World War II started, people were very much curious to know the language of their enemies, because when these armies would go on the war front, they have to be equipped with what the enemies are speaking amongst themselves. And that is the reason why these army soldiers were trained in the language of their enemy. So they have to become very good at understanding and remembering those set phrases. So this method, which is known as audiolingual method, employs mugging up sentences, repeating those model sentences over and over again, and imitating your teachers. So if you actually can relate it to your own life, when you go to another country altogether, for example, you visit China. Now, you'll memorize a few phrases so that you can actually communicate with the local Chinese people. Maybe you can memorize a phrase like, where can I get food? okay, so that when you speak that in Chinese, you'll be able to at least survive in China if people cannot communicate in English. So we do understand and know few phrases. Bengali mein kisi cheez ko kya kehte hai, we know that, right? We don't know entire Bengali, but then we know that certain phrase. So this habit of repeating the phrase again and again, this drill method, is known as the audiolingual method, in which you keep on repeating the set phrases, set patterns again and again. There was a question which was asked recently in the NET exam, that mechanical drill method is used to teach an acquired language or teach a second language in which method? So this mechanical drill tool is used as a tool in which method of language teaching? And the correct answer was audiolingual method, because in this you mechanically ask students to keep on repeating the set phrases. It's like a mechanical drill. So these were few very important and very interesting language teaching methods which are asked in NET exam, and also which will be beneficial if you teach somebody a new language. So with that note, I would like to give an end to this video. There are a lot of other methods which I have not yet covered in this video. For more details and to know more about these methods, you can go to my website and get the detailed list of language teaching method and get detailed audios and PDFs on the same if you join our online course. You can also subscribe to this YouTube channel so that you keep on receiving the new content that I'm posting specifically and exclusively for UGC NET aspirants. Follow me on all the social media platforms so that you don't miss out on any new updates. Also, at the same time, like, share and subscribe to this channel. Comment below if you have any other questions, any other doubts or any other topics on which you want me to make videos. That's it for this video lecture. We'll meet very soon in the next video lecture. Till the time we meet next, happy learning, keep loving literature and stay tuned to arpitakarwa.com.